Tonight, Seabass. What's up, brother? How are you, man?
Man, I'm blessed.
Man, God bless you. Man, what you think about all this in here?
Man, this is amazing, man.
Talking to the microphone.
This is amazing, man.
It's crazy, right?
This is awesome. This is awesome. I didn't even know stuff like this existed 2 years ago, man.
Okay, so that was your song called I Do This. What's the name of your album?
Name of my album is called Living by the Code. It's a mixtape.
Okay, good deal, man. Yeah. And I'm going to tell you briefly, I got to have to shout out to Alan, who works with me at His Hands Laser Engraving. He's the one who gave me your CD.
Okay, yeah.
And he said that you were at a prison ministry, and you were performing for the kids there, and he picked up your CD, and that's how he's been jamming to it this whole time. He was like, hey, check out this guy. I got it. The first time I heard it, I called you, and it's a wrap.
Yeah, man.
Oh, I can't say it's a wrap, can I, Juan? It's a wrap. I mean, that's the way it is. I mean, I Do This. You're going to hear Power, Letter to God, and Real Love. All those songs are banging, man.
Yeah, man.
So tell me where you're from.
I'm from Houston, Texas, 5th Ward, Cashmere Gardens, Crane Street, born and raised. Mama was raised there, aunt raised there, grandma from there, you know what I mean?
You know 007 from 5th Ward?
I've met him, yeah. He's actually on the CD.
I wasn't
in the studio with him, man, but I was blessed to record it at the studio. He recorded the song at, man, and he gave me the blessing to go ahead and leave it on there. So,
that's,
you know, 5th Ward boys. Man. I'm from 5th Ward, it gets no better.
Hey, man, so you're from here.
Yeah.
How long have you been doing this rap thing?
Man, it is crazy how guys work. I've been doing this rap thing since I was 16, man. But Christian-wise, man, just for about almost 2 years now, man. And God has done more with me in 2 years than I was able to do with myself in 8, man. You know what I mean?
Right.
So it's just amazing to me once I submitted to God the things that he could do, you know what I mean? I'm sitting here in clubs stressing myself out, smoking cigarettes, wondering why Soulja Boy blowing up, and I'm spitting real stuff, and I'm broke, you know? And then I say, all right, God, I give up. It's your game now, you know? And next thing I know, doors opening left and right, man. So, hey.
Hey, man, so were you saved and you got involved in rap, or were you rapped and then you got saved? How is that exactly?
Well, I've been writing, you know, forever, but I got saved when I was about 16 at the kitchen table at my uncle and my aunt's house, but you know what I'm saying? Like my brother here said, man, I had that fire insurance, man. I knew I wasn't going to hell, so, you know, I still wasn't living the way I needed to be living.
All right,
what I'm saying?
So we'll be right back with Seabass. This song is called Power.
Power, man. Listen
here
to what the power of God can do to your life.
On Generation Live.
My king, my king. He ain't the dirtiest king. Made a man, I was in the booth. this, I couldn't understand the things God could do if I was little man. I little man, now I benefit, I'm the free. My God is amazing. Power evident in his love, and it's life changing. No matter what I'm facing, I know I'm safe in his arms. I know that he's able, so I stay in his arms. I got a testimony to tell. I seen him do a lot, but I've never seen him fail.
All right, all right, all right. So, if you want to see Seabass, see, you want to see his smiling face, www.gliveradio.com. He's here with his wife and with everybody else, 1-800-808-5548. So, Letter to God.
Letter to God, man.
That's on this album, this track too, this album too, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That is a great song.
Oh, man, I appreciate that, man.
Tell me a little bit about Letter to God.
Letter to God, man, I'm 26 now, since about 17, man, I dealt with depression, man, for the fact of just wanting to live my own way, you know what I mean? And now I'm starting to conquer it because I'm starting to live the way God want me to live. And I was coming out of one of these down moments in my life. And I was like, man, I just want to write to God. I just want to talk. I just want to vent. You know what I'm saying? And be transparent. So I prayed, and that's what came.
Hey, man, so when we pray, we make ourselves transparent to our God.
Exactly. Yeah, I already know. You may as well give it up, you know?
I know. It's not like we could be, like, not praying about something and thinking about something else. You know, exactly. He's already going to know, right?
Exactly. Exactly.
Hey, man, I want to get to this track because it's a great track, okay?
No
doubt. would you do me a favor? Would you intro it?
Yeah, man. What's up, Houston? What's up, everybody else that's listening in? This is Letter to God off the mixtape Living by the Code.
I'm But I know your hand still perfected me. My first 21 years, I was dumb and this dumb, doing the work of this devil. What was calling this fun? Looking for freedom and everything except for your son. I stepped on the grace, and basically I spit in your space. A fire and shoot, Christian with a gun in my waist. A horrible witness, see your name, say this name. This strip club course was like a bastard's case. Like I didn't have a father that stood in my place. Took the beating that I should've got. Decision making is determined by your word and not a cold pill. I sit here and I'm amazed. I'm waiting for the day. You killed a broken man and you sent them on this way. What you say I'll do to live is you. The world must see how my God is true. Roll for me, so I ride for you. I live by the code like a soldier ought to do. It's all for you.
Oh yeah, Seabass in the building.
Yes, sir.
What y'all think about that? That was slamming, right? That was cool. I liked it a lot.
God, man.
Hey, man, so you're from here.
From here.
Where'd you go to school at?
I went to school at Humble High, man. I knew if I went to Wheatley, graduation was not going to see me. You know, so... So, you know, but I actually went to school for 2.5 years in Las Cruces, New Mexico. That's where my old man's from.
Oh, okay.
So I went to two years there, and then I did the last 2.5 at Humble.
Nice.
Yeah.
Hey, man, so who have you shared the stage with?
With Furious Styles, man. He's a dude, man, that has blessed me tremendously in the Christian hip-hop scene in Houston, tremendously, I believe, man. He lets a lot of cats come in there and just record for free, man, and he blesses them, man, and he does a great job mixing it. Mm-hmm. So I shared the stage with him. Some cats from my local church, man, Driven, you know what I'm saying, my boy Justin, You know, and mainly just those cats, man, and going to the prison and doing things with them like that, man. So it's been a real blessing. You know what I mean?
Good deal. Good deal. Yeah. Just a question, bro. How long have you been married?
Man, we've been married for 3 years, man. Almost 4 in November.
Because every time I ask you a question, she smiles behind you.
Man, that's, hey, that's my road down there, man. That's my ace, man.
Good deal, man. So this last song is called Real Love.
Yeah.
Now tell everybody one more time, what's the name of your album?
The album is Living by the Code. Okay. Living by the Code, you know, we grow up living by the G Code where I'm from, man. And the main rule is die for your partner that's gonna die for you, ride for your partner that's gonna ride for you. And the whole thing with this mixtape is if you really living by that code, you're gonna be willing to ride for God and die for God because Christ done already did it.
That's interesting. You know what I'm saying? Interesting. What would you say about young people right now that are doing some things to try to get other people to like them and, you know, they're caught up in all that? What would you say?
Man, I would tell them, I would have to hit them with Solomon, man, and tell them vanity, man. Nah, but on the real, man, I would say, man, you know what? The main homie and the main person you need to be rolling with is Christ, man. Because I done seen it, and a lot of these cats here, you done heard them tell you they done seen it. And man, doing what everybody else doing and what they want you to do ain't gonna do nothing but head you down a dead end, man, and you're gonna bump your head, man.
Hey, so, because those friends,
yeah,
are not friends.
They're not friends. A real friend is gonna love you like God love you. You know what I'm saying? They're gonna tell you the things God wants you to hear. Hmm. You know what I mean? They're gonna tell you the things that God wants you to do.
They're gonna tell you the truth.
The truth.
They're gonna look at you in the eye, they're gonna shake your hand, and they're gonna be your friend.
Exactly.
Because the Bible says that Jesus is our friend.
Yes.
He sticks closer to us than a brother.
Yes.
He sticks closer than a brother.
Yes.
And so we'll come back. This song is called Real Love.
Real Love. It's dedicated to my beautiful wife, man.
All right, man. Here we are on Generation Live. Real Love right there by Seabass. Yeah. Now, who's this song dedicated to?
It's dedicated to my beautiful wife, Isabel Petty, straight out that Acre Shakers, man.
Oh, my goodness, my goodness. Man, on that note, man, real love, man, tell me about what Christ has done in your life, man. And I want you to lead somebody to the Lord. I want you to say the sinner's prayer. We'll all say it in here with you. Don't make it too complicated and crazy, all right? But yeah. and then we'll come back, and I got some more questions to ask you. How about that? Yeah. So what has God done in your life, bro?
Man, God, I'm just amazed to be here, man. I said in the song, me and my wife, we was both hood rats. It ain't hard to see. You know, God took us, man, from a situation that, you know, I thought I was stuck in the G code, man. I thought I was stuck. It was times people told me to come get the gun, we got something to do, and I felt like I had to do it because I was raised to live a certain way. Not by my mama, not by my dad, but when they opened that door, that's what the streets told me, you know? So God saved me from that, man. He was constantly pricking at my heart. He pulled me and he said, Seabass, look, you can get 25 like your little cousin did when he was 16, or you can follow me, man. And I just felt, man, I hit that brick wall and I was looking up, literally depressed out of my mind, man, because I had went and robbed somebody, man. And I was depressed because I was just thinking, man, I could have killed him and God was watching me, man. So, man, I just say, man, slow down, pump your brakes before you run into that brick wall, man, because everybody's not blessed to be like me and be like my homies from Brownsville, man, that can sit here and tell you this story. Some of them locked up doing 50, man, and they ain't going to get to tell you this story on the radio. And I don't want you to be that person. You feel what I'm saying? So go ahead and give it up now. All you right. know what I mean? And the thing is, like I said, we living by the code, then this is what you need to do. You need to ride for the person, Jesus Christ, who done already rode for you and died for you. Open up your heart if you feeling like you tired of that loneliness, you tired of the streets, you tired of the hustle, you tired of the pain. Open up your heart. Let him in. And he will come in and do mighty works like he's done in my life amen. And everybody's life in this room, man.
Amen, amen.
So if you want to do that, just say this prayer in your heart. Say this prayer with me. Dear Heavenly Father,
dear Heavenly Father,
I am a sinner. Without you, I can never be. Without you, I will never see. Open up my eyes, God. Free me from this pain.
Free me from this misery.
God, I accept your son, Jesus.
I accept his death.
I believe in his burial. And I believe in his resurrection. Father, change my life. Help me to live for you. In the name of your son, Jesus, I pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Man, I appreciate that, man. If you did accept Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, man, get with me, Albert at GLiveRadio.com, or you can give me a call here, 1-800-808-5548. Man, I appreciate you, Pastor Jeremy, man. Thank you so much for staying here, man. True heart, true man of God, true youth minister right there. Appreciate you, little Jeremy. Coming on through, man.